8 years ago, President Barack Obama looked fresh-faced and young. Now he looks like somebody's pop-pop. Does holding the highest office in the land age people faster? Hey, Village Elders, Trace here for DNews. The President of the United States of America is likely one of the most stressful jobs around. On call 24 hours a day, constantly visible by the world's media, citizens, and of course, enemies, being the leader of the free world is bound to take its toll after 4 or 8 years. Commonly, people cite pictures of presidents and how much grayer or aged they end up looking. Obama quipped to the fresh-faced Canadian PM Justin Trudeau, "If you don't want to go gray like me, you need to start dyeing your hair soon before it's too late." But do presidents actually age faster? Today, the president never goes anywhere without the physician to the president, and meticulous records of the president's health care, of course, are kept. So, Dr. Michael Roizen, chief wellness officer at the Cleveland Clinic, looked at records from every president from Teddy Roosevelt to George W. Bush to find a pattern, and he thinks that presidents age twice as fast. Roizen looked at the commander-in-chief's diet, blood pressure, physical activity, and lifestyle, finding the level of chronic stress was high, and the ability to blow off steam with friends and family, which would lessen stress, was low. Stress has huge effects on the human body. Things like immune system response, cardiovascular function, motivation, and mood, not to mention how your body processes food and how much fat you store, those are all worsened and affected by stress. And it also affects aging. A study in Nature Genetics found chronic exposure to stress will shorten telomeres. Telomeres are the chunk of DNA on the end of each of our chromosomes. Think the things at the tips of your shoelaces, which are called aglets, by the way. We've talked about these before. As they replicate, the telomeres shrink and the DNA eventually becomes more easily damaged. Scientists think that this is what causes aging, and according to many studies, stress increases the telomere shortening process and thus increases the speed of aging. The thing is, Roizen, he's just one opinion. Another doctor, Jay Olshansky of the University of Illinois Chicago, disagrees with him. Olshansky believes wealth, education, and healthcare access should all increase presidential lifespan, and modern-day presidents definitely have those. It is incredible how much wealth, education, and healthcare access helps people live longer, healthier lives, am I right? But what if they're both right? What if because of chronic stress while in the White House, presidents age faster, but then because of their access to wealth and healthcare, they live better lives after their terms end? This might be true, but according to a study in the British Medical Journal, presidents and heads of state die sooner. Researchers tracked how many years they lived after a candidate's last election. 279 national leaders in 17 countries from 1722 until 2015 were studied, and they found elected leaders live 4.4 fewer years than their unelected brethren. Yikes. One thing is without a doubt, over the last 8 years, Barack Obama is getting grayer up top. In fact, a study in Proceedings of the National Institute of Science compared his hair over time. They found he was in fact getting grayer at 0.452% per year when compared to the actor Morgan Freeman. Science is awesome. Look, there have only been 44 presidents so far, and only a handful are alive at any given time. To study them as a group is really difficult, and it might just be all in our heads. According to Dr. Olshansky, Obama is not necessarily aging faster. We just notice because he's always out there. We are watching him change. So when we see an old picture, it's just a shock. See, this is crazy, right? Ugh. Stress has all sorts of different effects aside from the ones mentioned here. You can check out this video and find out all of them.
Most of the short-term effects of stress are the result of this fight-or-flight response. The adrenal gland, which sits on top of your kidneys, releases the hormones in response to some stressor. This in turn releases glucose into your bloodstream to power you up, ready to take on a threat.
Do you guys feel like stress makes you age or the president? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews every single day. I'll see you next time.